Well, we're certainly off to a gloomy start out there. Plenty of gray, and you can't even really see the downtown skyline there from our airport skycam. We're about freezing, though. That's good news. That means none of this is freezing on the roadways, at least here in the metro. We're at 36 for a temperature of feels like of 28. East winds coming in at 10 miles per hour. Live Super Doppler HD coming in pretty much dry for us, unless you head way off to the west towards Council Bluffs. A couple of flurries over there. We had more of those early this morning. Those are moving just north of Sioux City at this point. We just have some clouds left over, and we'll keep that around this morning. A little bit of fog and possibly even a little bit of drizzle coming at us at some point. Here's our temperatures. We have low 30s to the north, so maybe a couple of frozen spots on the roadways, especially bridges, overpasses, as we're just now hitting that freezing mark over the last hour or two north. 34 for Ottumwa, 33 right now in Lamoni. Very cold off to the north. In fact, Arctic air and negative 8 right now in International Falls, 3 above 0. Bismarck, North Dakota, as you head down to the south, some low 40s into St. Louis, so big difference in temperatures. You can tell there's a boundary here, and there is a boundary. We're on the warm side of it, relatively speaking. Very cold off to the north and west. That's where they're seeing the snow showers. And here's a storm system we're watching right here, down into just west of the panhandle of Oklahoma. That's going to be riding right along this boundary over the next 24 hours or so, and it ends up right in southeast Iowa, northeast Missouri by early tomorrow morning, and that puts the sweet spot for snow just off to into north central portions of the state. So here's our winter storm watch. These areas could see 3 to 6 inches of snow. This is between 6 p.m. today and noon Wednesday. That's the duration of this, and it goes just off to the west as well. So that's where I think the biggest totals are going to be. Although we could see some snow here in the metro, it doesn't look like it will be nearly as impressive. Southeast Iowa may not see any snow at all, probably won't. It looks like mainly rain. 9 o'clock this morning, you see the clouds continuing to be around. Noon clouds. Here comes the rain by about 3 or 4 this afternoon. Even a couple of thunderstorms from Des Moines south eastward possible. Best chance down towards Ottumwa. You see that rain snow mix? There's that pink by 6 p.m. just west of the metro down towards Lamoni. That slides on through tonight. You see more blue as well. This is 11 p.m. Steady snow showers up towards Fort Dodge into the northwest corner of the state. We're going to be right on that transition zone here in the metro. So I think as we head through the overnight hours, we're likely to see just a little bit of light snow. Better chance early tomorrow morning. And it looks like the rainfall is going to mainly impact the southeast corner of the state, half inch possible from Des Moines down towards Ottumwa, Lamoni as well. But then snowfall could see an inch or two possibly here in the metro. Heavier amounts north, again, 3 to 6 inches up towards Algona, Humboldt, Charles City as well, 2 or 3 inches over towards Sioux City and Council Bluffs. Here's what we're looking at for temperatures. Mid to upper 30s, couple low 40s out there. I think we'll be one of those here in the metro that hits the low 40s, mostly cloudy. Rain moves in mid to late afternoon. Tonight, temperatures go back down near freezing, so we'll likely mix rain and snow, possibly changing to snow before daybreak tomorrow. And if we don't do it before daybreak, we'll likely do it during the morning hours of Wednesday. We do eventually end up above freezing, though, so probably back to rain, snow, if not just rain, if we have any moisture left over during the day Wednesday. And then it's all out of here by Thursday. Friday, we're looking at better conditions. We could hit the 50s by Friday, and we have more chances in the 8-day as well. Next week, we may do it again.